Hello, Michelle. This is the ISUPK out of 1 West, 125th Street, Harlem, New York, under Commandant General Yohana. Since 1969, we have been teaching at Black, Hispanics, and Native Indians are the lost 12 tribes of Israel. You understand? And what has been going on since slavery? You understand? The Christian church that has been set up since slavery is a whole house. That is what the Christian church really is. It's a whole house of Satan. You understand? What is a whore? A whore is a woman that has more than one man. That is a whore. The pastor does encourage every single Christian woman in the church to become whores. That is what the pastor does do in the Christian church.
That's right.
You understand? That is why I want wives. Rather listen to the pastor than listen to she husband at home. You understand? That is why you ask all those prostitutes in Morris Street, what religion are they? They will say Christian. Because Christianity promotes prostitution and whoring. That is what the pastor teach in the Christian church. You understand? Since the days of slavery, the Christian church has always been a whorehouse for women. You understand? And on top of that, the pastor here just teach lies. He molests people. He rapes people. He robs us. The Christian leader, he's just a liar and a hypocrite. You must not listen to our Christian leaders. Black on black crime is a result because of the Christian church. You want to know why there's so much drug dealers in the every ghetto? It's because of the Christian church.
Right.
Because of the Christian church, that is why we have so much drugs and guns in the black community. You understand? So when you see a drug dealer selling drugs, or you see black on black crime, don't blame them. Yes, they're wrong, but don't blame them. Blame the pastor for encouraging drugs.
That's right.
Go in the black community. Blame the pastor for encouraging drugs or guns to go in the black community.
Right.
You understand? And also blame the pastor for all of these diseases and plagues that coming on the face of the earth right now.
That's right.
AIDS is a result of the Christian church. Hepatitis A is a result of the Christian church.
Right.
You understand? The coronavirus is a result of the Christian church.
That's right.
The Christian church is responsible for the coronavirus today.
Right.
And we are going to prove it. We are going to prove it in the scriptures and with history. Because that's what we just do in this school here, in the ISUPK. We prove every single thing that we say. You understand? What they say, the coronavirus started through eating bats. Because I eaten bats in Wuhan, China. That is how the coronavirus started. Well, guess what? Hepatitis A started from what? Eating shellfish. Eating shellfish is a result of getting hepatitis A. And your pastor does teach you to eat bat, crab, manicou, pork, and shellfish. Your pastor is a result of all these diseases on the face of the earth today.
That's right.
Do not blame nothing else but blame your pastor.
The book of Leviticus, chapter 11 and verse 19. And the stork, and the heron after her kind, and the lapwing, and the bat, all fowls that creepeth, going on all four, shall be an abomination unto you.
Right, so you all hear that, right? The Lord said the bat, that is the main one we're picking out of that scripture. The bat is an abomination unto you. What is an abomination? Abomination is something that goes against God. That is an abomination. The Lord said to do not eat bats. But yet still, others still want to eat bats. The Lord said do not eat crab and manicou. But we still eat manicou. The Lord said do not eat it. And I don't want to know why the coronavirus coming. The coronavirus is coming because your pastor telling you to eat bats in the Christian church. That is why the coronavirus coming.
That's right.
There's no other reason. Hand sanitizers can't save you. You understand? Keeping social distance can't save you. Once you stop eating bat and manicou and crab, you will not get the coronavirus. You understand? We have the ways right here in this Bible.
Right.
It tells you how not to get diseases.
That's right.
You understand? But your pastor does not tell us how not to get diseases. Your pastor makes us get AIDS. Your pastor encourages people to have sex with whores. Your pastor encourages the wives to have sex with more than one husband. Your pastor encourages homosexuality in the Christian church.
Right, right.
That is why we get AIDS, because of the pastor and what he tells us to eat and what he tells us to do, right? So we are not affiliated with any religious organization on the face of the earth.
Right.
We are not Christians. We are not Muslim. We are not Buddhists. We are not Hindus. We are the ISUPK out of 1 West 125th Street, Harlem, New York, under Commander General Ehana. You understand? This book is not a religious book. The Bible is not a religious book. You understand? The Bible is a book that God gave laws to one race of people on the face of the earth.
Right.
And God says, if any of my people, any black man or black woman, eat pork or crab or shrimp and lobster, I will send the coronavirus and they will die. But when we go in church, the pastor tells me we can eat all of those things. So again, if you want to know why the coronavirus is coming out, blame your Christian leader. Blame the pastor for coronavirus. Blame your pastor for AIDS. Blame your pastor for H1N1.
Influenza, the flu. In 1918, the influenza pandemic was the most severe pandemic in recent history. It was caused by an H1N1 virus with genes of avian origin. Although there is no universal consensus regarding where the virus originated, it spread worldwide during 1918 and 1919. This is the CDC, Center of Disease Control and Prevention.
Right, so he read from the Center on Disease Control Prevention, right?
Yeah.
Right. So this is an article telling you here, it had other pandemics before. This is not the only pandemic it had on the earth. It had other pandemics on the earth before, which was, they was called the Spanish flu.
Right.
Since 1918. You understand? They was calling it the Spanish flu.
That's right.
You understand? That really originated from eating unlawful animals that God tell us not to eat, but your pastor telling us to eat it. You understand? It started from birds, they say. Birds and the pigs eating the birds, and humans cutting up the pigs and eating it. You understand? That is where that Spanish flu comes from. And it killed over 100 million people. And the Lord told us not to be eating all these kinds of animals, but we still want to eat these animals. Why? The Lord told us not to have sex with whores, but we still want to have sex with whores. You understand? But why are we doing it? Because the pastor said it is right to have sex with whores. Your pastor said it is right to eat bats and manicou,
right,
and crab.
Right, right.
That is why we get coronavirus. Your pastor is responsible for the coronavirus and nobody else. You understand? You're really cool.
The book of Leviticus, chapter 11 and verse 7. And the swine, though he divide the hoof and be cloven footed, yet he cheweth not the cud. He is unclean to you.
Right? So the Lord say, the swine, which is a pig, the Lord say, do not eat no pig. The pig is unclean to you. So why it is y'all still eating pig? Why y'all still eating pig? The Lord say pig is unclean to you. Clean animals in the Bible is cow. A cow is a clean animal. You can eat a cow. You can eat a sheep. You can eat a goat. Once it is lawful, you can eat it. But a pig, the Lord said, do not eat pig. You understand? It has certain animals that was created to clean the earth. It eating all kind of feces and all kind of nastiness on the earth. And then we come in to eat it after. No, that's why the Lord said, do not eat those unclean beasts. Also, AIDS. They say AIDS come from a monkey. AIDS dead come from a monkey. Those shames on them in the Congo and Africa. You understand? You know everybody loves to say we're African, but we is not no stinking African. You understand? We are Israelites by blood. Not because your black in complexion means it's an African.
Right,
because
right.
Therefore we can say Kamla is African too. If everybody who black is African, then Kamla Persad Bisesa is African. You understand? Because she black too. You understand? You are black by where your bloodline come from. That is what makes you a black man or an Israelite according to the scriptures.
Right.
You are an Israelite. Wherever your bloodline comes from, that is who your father is or who your race is. If an African bloodline comes from Africa, that person is African. If an East Indian bloodline comes from East India, that person is an East Indian.
Right.
On their father's side. That's what the scriptures say.
How many people have died of HIV?
Right, so there's how much people have died of HIV. Right.
Despite reversals in AIDS deaths, challenges remain. Expanded access to antiretroviral therapy has profoundly lowered the rate of HIV-related deaths, both in the US and globally. Some of the greatest reversals have been in sub-Sahara Africa, the region which accounts to 75% of all HIV infections. AIDS in 2018, according to the WHO, 32 million people have died of HIV since the beginning of the epidemic.
Right, so since the epidemic of AIDS has come upon the face of the earth, which started from people eating monkeys. Humans eating monkeys is what started the AIDS epidemic. By eating unlawful animals is what started all these diseases. You understand? AIDS is one of them from eating monkeys. That's how AIDS come about. You understand? And 300 million people have died from it. And go ahead, come on.
According to WHO, 32 million people have died of HIV since the beginning of the epidemic. Out of 75.9 million who have been affected. Moreover, of the 37.9 million people living with HIV today, just over 770,000 died in 2018.
Right, so just over 700,000 people died of AIDS in 2018. Because why? They want to eat monkey. Monkey is the reason why AIDS came about, from eating monkeys. You understand? We have the cure here or what to prevent you from getting all these diseases. If we all used to listen to this Bible and stop eating these unlawful animals,
that's right.
You all would not have get AIDS in the first place. You all would not have get those diseases, hepatitis A. You all would not get coronavirus. Hand sanitizers cannot save you. You understand? But guess what? Since all these diseases come about, the men in this school, we are still here. The men in this school, we are still here.
Straight.
Because why? We keep the laws and the Most High.
That's right.
That is why we are still here. If you stop eating pork, crab, shrimp, and lobster, and bats, and monkeys, you all will not get to get these diseases. Hand sanitizers cannot save you. Social distancing can't save you. But you have to keep the laws of God. That is what could save you. Obeying the laws of God is what could save the black man and the black woman from getting sick upon the face of the earth. There's no other cure but the Most High.
The origin of HIV and AIDS. The link between HIV and SIV. HIV is a type of lentivirus, which means it attacks the immune system.
Right, so the HIV attacks the immune system. Right, so you're going to find the link now between this HIV and SIV. Where's the link? Because it says it comes from monkeys. You understand? So let me see where it really comes from.
In a similar way, the simian immunodeficiency virus SIV attacks the immune system of monkeys and apes. Research found that HIV is related to SIV, and there are many similarities between the two viruses. HIV-1 is closely related to a strain of SIV found in chimpanzees, and HIV-2 is closely related to a strain of SIV found in certain mammals.
Right, so HIV found in humans and the SIV found in the chimpanzees or the monkeys, but it has a link between the HIV and the SIV in monkey. What is the link? You want to find out here the origins of it. You understand? That is how we get AIDS from eating monkeys in Africa, in the Congo. You understand? That is how it came about, because we want to eat what we want to eat. But why we want to eat these things, what we want to eat? Because the pastor saying the laws of God don't have it. You can do what you want. The pastor saying you can eat pork and bat and manicou when those things are sin against God. God said not eat manicou, but unless still eating manicou. The Lord said not eat a rabbit, but unless still eating rabbit.
Well, how did HIV cross from chimps to humans? The most commonly accepted theory is that of the hunter. In this scenario, SIV was transferred to humans as a result of chimps being killed and eaten, right, by their blood getting into cuts or wounds on people in the course of hunting.
Right, so that is what they said. We used to cut open the chimpanzees and eat them, and that is how we get AIDS. AIDS come about from eating monkeys in Africa. You understand? And then the white man have the dare to say that we is Africans. We is not no stinking Africans. We are Israelite by blood.
That's right.
Only Israelites is the number one on the face of the earth.
That's right.
You ain't see nobody killing out Africans. You see them killing out Israelites though. Israelites, you see them killing out. And on top of that, the number one people in sports is Israelites. People that came off the slave ships. We is the number one in sports, not them in Africa. We is the number one in basketball.
Right.
Tennis.
That's right.
Black people that came off the slave ships, not them in Africa. You understand? The Hispanic people is the number one in football, not them in Africa.
That's right.
You understand? That is a proof that we are not Africans. It's two different people. Your pastor cares about his loss more than your goddamn life. Your pastor does not care about your life. Your pastor cares about his loss. All your pastor wants to do is to have sex with whoever he wants to have sex with and eat whatever he wants to eat. That is all your pastor cares about. Your pastor don't give a damn about black people. Your pastor don't give a damn about the Native Indians. Your pastor don't give a damn about the Hispanics and them. All your pastor cares about is who he wants to have sex with and whatever he can eat. That is what the pastor cares about in the Christian church.
That's right.
Stop going to the Christian church. The Christian church is the number one cause for black-on-black crime.
That's right.
The Christian church is the number one cause for drug dealers in the ghettos.
That's right.
The Christian church is the number one cause for guns in the ghettos.
Right.
Your Christian pastor is the reason why black people suffering,
that's right,
dying,
that's right,
in the ghetto every day.